minute, think about it, that's a billy.
What's going on, folks? This is VK Jones here. Just chilling, doing what we got to do on Hash It Out Show. We got a Hash It Out VK Jones exclusive for you. We've been working on this for a long time, and it's good to have this person here. We did a lot of arrangements, but we're here with him right now. He's going to talk with us a little bit about his career, going to chop it up with the NFL Hall of Famer from the Indianapolis Colts, Mr. Edgerrin Ames. What's going on with you, man?
Hey, what's up, man? I'm glad to have you, man. Glad we can make it work, man. You know, you're real creative, real versatile, and doing whatever it takes to make it work. So we're going to make this work, going to make it good, and get the people what they need.
Appreciate it, appreciate it. First of all, welcome to the city. You know, you've been here a couple of times before, but you're here again and everything. So, first of all, let me ask you this. What were your thoughts when you got the call that you're going to be inducted to the NFL Hall of Fame?
Oh, man, you know, it's a process. It's a process that's been going on for years. And once it was official and once it finally happened, you know, it's one of the things that every player wishes and dreams for. So just like anybody else that's gotten that call, man, I was super excited. I was happy that everything happened. And, you know, it makes all your hard work and effort seem worth it, you know, because you started at 7-8 years old and played football until you're 30-something and ended up in the highest, the Pro Football Hall of Fame. That's the highest of the high.
Absolutely.
You know, that's the maximum level you can go, so I maxed out my football career.
Absolutely, absolutely. That is big for you, and I know it was big for your family and everything, especially your son. Your son, a very good basketball player, 4 to 5 stars. We seen him in New Orleans, Jizzle James. What it means to him more than anything else when you got the call, seeing that his father's an NFL Hall of Famer, and how you feel on him just really trying to make a name for himself.
Yeah, for a child of a Hall of Famer, anytime, like, we're big on family. So anything happens good in our family, you know, we're big on it. So for them, that's a big moment for them because they get a chance to see their father go through, do everything it took to become one of the greatest ever to play the game. And also, you're giving them the blueprint. So you give them the blueprint, you let them know, like, these are the things that you have to do. It's not no easy road, it's a very disciplined road, and you got to have a lot of things that work in your favor. So it was one of those things that there's nothing bad can come up out of.
Absolutely. And then looking at the past way back, you know what I'm saying? You have a lot of connections in the local Louisiana area. You play with a couple of great athletes at the University of Miami. You got connections with Ed Reed and also Reggie Wayne. Some great players. Peyton Manning you also play with as well. New Orleans is more than anything else. How you felt the time that you spent playing with these guys and also being good friends, having a good relationship with those guys?
You know, I think when you look at the relationship, you know, you meet a lot of people throughout your journey. And there's certain people that become lifelong friends. And for somehow, some reason, whatever it is, it's something in New Orleans with New Orleans. So, like, all my close, like, I got a lot of close friends from New Orleans. You know, everybody I met from here, you know, they've been very hospitable. They've been real good to me. And we actually developed a relationship that's lifelong. And there's nothing bad you can say. You know, I don't know what it is about this place, but they got a certain type of flavor that, you know, that we kind of connected with. You know, like, you talk about P, you talk about Reggie, you talk about Ed Reed, even Marshall Falk from this way, and also Ali, you know, Oliver Celestine, that's my man. So I'm in New Orleans 1 or 2 times a year, and the city always shows number of love.
No, absolutely. That's what New Orleans is about. We're Southern hospitality down here. That's what it is, and I know you're liking and everything else, especially the difference between here and Florida and everything. But also, you know, you and Ed Reed pretty tight and everything. You know, Ed Reed had got a job at over at Bethune-Cookman. Things didn't really work out, you know. But what are your thoughts? Did you think he did everything he can to handle the situation the best way he could?
I mean, you know, we're on to the next, man. I don't even sit back on the situation. Everybody moved on. You know, we did what he did. He went in with good intentions. For whatever reason, it didn't work. And now, it's like in football, you got to put a bad play behind you. You know, you just got to keep moving forward. and just keep chasing greatness. So that's the way I look at that situation. There's not much to talk about or even dwell on because everybody's moving forward.
Well, talking about your NFL career over in Indianapolis, all your years there, you know, what it was like making the adjustment from the University of Miami to playing for the Indianapolis Colts and being in Indianapolis, Indiana?
Well, you know, at the University of Miami, I played with a coach that had been in the pro ranks. So I already kind of had the system down. And then, you know, you go to the pros, and the difference is there's no homework you got to do for school. You don't have to go to class. Football becomes life, like literally. You know, every day you're in class, but it's all about football. You know, back when you was at school, it was about the studies and academics. So it actually became easier for a true football player. And the adjustment was made seamless. And I think my career kind of speaks for itself because, you know, I went in and did what I always been doing. But it was a great transition, but for me it was a little bit different and a little easier, I think, because of coming from the University of Miami.
Well, looking at it, had a great overall career at Indianapolis and everything, legend of the Hall of Fame. I know you wanted to get, I don't know if you have a Super Bowl ring or not or whatever, but at the same time, playing on a couple of championships, how it was with the experience. I know the timing was rough at first, but when y'all got it down pat, you and Peyton Manning, Marvin Harrison, everybody else, you guys took off to the next level for that team.
Well, you know, it was never rough because, you know, when I went to a team that was 3-13, and in my first year, we turned 13-3. So it was never rough there. You know, it's just a progression as far as building and trying to get to that championship level. And you have to learn that, you have to earn that. You know, that's one thing that we continue to do. And as time went on, the coach were able to make that happen. But it was all in the making. You know, it was all part of the process. And I think any championship team, you'll just pop up and become a champion. You earn it.
And what are your thoughts that you guys are being recognized as Hall of Famers? Peyton Manning is going to get there soon. And then all of a sudden, Peyton's already in. You know, I don't mess up like that. Peyton Manning's in. Marvin Harrison's in. And now you're in. It's amazing. It seems like the Colts continue to be recognized of that great era that they had.
Yeah, you know, we did some great things, and I think it goes down in history, and that's what the Hall of Fame is about. It's about people that made history and had an impact on the game. And now we're just waiting on a couple more players to come on in and join us. You know, you got to, when Reggie get a chance to get in, that's going to be great for us. When Dwight Freeney get a chance to get in, that's going to be great for us and the organization. You know, it's good to see your family or your brothers get in, especially the one that you actually built this whole thing with.
Absolutely, and we're hoping Reggie does get in. I'm thinking he's next too. I agree with you. I think he's going to be next of all the great Colts to get in to the Hall of Fame. And then also Jeff Saturday, hopefully he gets in sooner or later. But at the same time, great teammates had over at Indianapolis. Now, let's talk about a little bit of the University of Miami. I know you got some little stories, but at the same time, you know, how it was with the transition from high school going into the University of Miami once you settled in?
Well, the transition from high school to the University of Miami was pretty much a bunch of unknowns. You know, you really don't know how good you are until you compare or line up against those guys that actually were 4 stars, 5 stars, or top rated. You know, when you're playing high school, you just play against your area. And you can be the best in your area, but a different ball game when you got to be the best of the best amongst all everybody else that comes in. So that was the only difference in going from high school to college. You know, you get a chance to really see these guys that are 4-star, 5-star, and you get a chance to compete with them on a daily basis versus every now and then.
What is your favorite moment at the University of Miami? I know there was plenty of great games you had. One, I can definitely put a little memory to you. You had a breakout game against UCLA. And you spoiled their chances of getting to a national championship game. And it kind of helped me out in the pocket a bit. But what was one of your favorite moments?
Well, University of Miami has so many moments, so I don't never pick one that really just trumps the other. You know, everything is situational. But, you know, of course, there are a lot of people like to bring up that UCLA game. That was a great game. And it was one of those things that you wish you could top your career off like that. And I was able to accomplish that. But to put one moment over the other, it'll be kind of doing my time at the University of Miami a disservice because we had some good moments there.
Absolutely. And at the same time,
You look at it. You're finished over there and everything. Can you tell me one good little story out of the University of Miami? One of your not just favorites, but one of your funny moments or whatever that happened at University of Miami.
I mean, you got to be there, man. You got to get involved, get in that locker room, and you'll hear so many stories. Like, for me, just to point one out, I never do that. You know, but you get around the guys,
gotcha.
There's so many things that pop out. So it's hard to just really say this or that. You know, that ain't never been my style.
Good answer on that one. Good answer, my friend. But another question I wanted to ask you. I always, you know, watching Miami growing up and everything else, and between me and you, I hate to say it, I'm a Knowles fan, but I always respected how the program is. Do you think Miami football has not been too much of the same since the Orange Bowl left? Because that was probably one of the toughest places to play college football.
Well, a lot of things have transpired, you know. You have to remember, when you have as many guys go to the NFL of one team, it's going to affect the program. And so everything kind of went downhill from there. And then we had the sanctions and all those things that took place. But if you really look at the culture of the University of Miami and the type of players, you know, they just need to get Florida kids, you need to get the Southern kids, get the Louisiana kids that they got back in the day. Now you see all the top schools, they're coming to get, they took the blueprint. And they're actually doing the same thing that we did back in the day. And so if we just keep our talent home, and these kids come out and play football the way they're supposed to play football, University of Miami will be all right.
Absolutely. And I wanted to ask you one more question. How are you enjoying your retirement, man? I know you're enjoying life. You got some content a little bit. You're out there just doing your thing, but also you're spending a lot of time with your family and everything else. How it is, how you enjoying your retirement out the NFL?
No, retirement is great. You know, I retired from football. I never retired from, you know, the business world. I like being outside, I like making things happen. I like to have fun, but also like to chase fun, you feel me? So that's what we do every day, man. We get out here, we're gonna make sure we mix and match with everybody and try to find a lane that we can capitalize off of, but also don't miss out on the fruits of your labor and having fun every day.
What you can, and one more thing, what you can say about how yourself still keeping up with things life after football, but not just that, at least like Shaquille O'Neal, Peyton Manning, being entrepreneurs and doing what they got to do to keep things going, to keep that legacy going.
Well, you know, it's all preference. You know, whatever you're into, you really can dive into it because you don't have really constraints or you don't have things that stop you. You know, you get to really be yourself and jump out there and do things that you really love. Like me, everything you see me doing, I'm really interested in doing it. And that's the beauty of being in this position now. Before, you have to do things to get to this stage, but now I'm at a point to where the things you see me doing, those things I really enjoy doing.
Edgerrin James, I appreciate you. NFL Hall of Famer, bro.
Appreciate you, man. Appreciate you having me on your show, man. Anytime you need me, you know, pull up, man. We be in the club setting. I don't care where it's at. We do it. We get it done. That's how we do. We make it happen wherever.
Absolutely. Appreciate it. And hopefully I'll get an invitation one of these days to come on your podcast or whatever, you know, just to talk sports or talk life, you know?
Yeah,
it's all
anytime,
good.
Anytime, just let me know. Pull up. And we rock out. You know how it goes, man. The vibes don't change.
Absolutely. That is Edgerrin James, my friend. Thank you so much. This is Hash It Out Show, and this is an exclusive. Appreciate you joining us out here, myself.
Yeah, hang with my boy, man. We're doing that outside in the middle of the nightlight, having fun. That's a 2-for-1, man. We got a 2-for-1 going on. My man doing whatever it takes to make things happen. That says a lot about you, my brother.
Thank you, sir. Edgerrin James, BK Jones, out.
Sinatra. Tell me what you know about real life. Tell me what you know about dark nights. I'm Bruce Wayne in the game. You just perpetrating from the sideline. What it feel like? Metaphor game too silly. Punchlines way too silly. The Millie, now I'm coming for that William. Hold on, wait a minute. Think about it. That's a Billy. Woo.